I follow Artemis fairly intensely. Here's the bits and pieces I've picked up about Alpaca, or DHLS, or Angry Face Lander Mick Angry Face. First off, Alpaca uses methane. It has never used hydrogen. If you take anything away from this video, it is to abuse people who say otherwise. Anyway, history. Back in early 2020, it had drop tanks. These were dropped in August 2020, changing it to a single stage lander. Drop tanks do give you an easier time on mass margins because you can effectively decrease dry mass, but I suspect reuse desires push them towards removing them. The bid was due in December 2020, and in that time, they weren't able to optimize the design to handle the tighter margins. This resulted in the negative mass margins. If you're going to take a second thing away from this video, it's that the issue with negative mass margins was with not having enough delta V, not with thrust to weight ratio. Because you will need to have an incredibly overweight lander not to have sufficient thrust to overcome lunar gravity. I estimate that Alpaca should experience about 40 kilonewtons of force due to lunar gravity, and that should be well within the reaches of the four main engines. Whereas if you even have a slight shortfall in mass margins, you suddenly might not have the required delta V of about 5 kilometers a second. And by the way, if your lander doesn't have sufficient thrust to take off from the surface, I have bad news about potential outcomes of the landing approach. The reason why I emphasize this is because in Gal's assessment of the situation, they thought it was a thrust to weight ratio issue. So the people whose job it was to assess the validity of the technical assessments didn't actually understand the basic principles of the situation. And that's somewhat scary. Onwards and upwards. These are the basic design parameters I'm expecting of the lander. Take them as you will. It has two docking ports, one for crew transfer on the side, and one for refilling the lander on the top. That's interesting, I suppose. The underlying technology has been progressing for a while now. Launch-wise, it's currently planned to launch Alpaca on Vulcans, with one carrying the lander and four carrying Methalox propellant tankers. There's also potential for a fifth tanker on the more straining missions. These tankers will probably use the same main engine and systems used on Alpaca. I can't give you accurate mass numbers for these because it's hard to determine what orbit it will stage in, because you can reasonably use anything from LEO to TLI with them. The only thing I can say with them is that they end up delivering roughly 8 tons of propellant to Alpaca. Historically, they had Centaur take care of power and propulsion on these tankers, but I suspect after the option A source selection gave them a ding for limiting to one provider, they switched to a tanker that could launch on any reasonably sized commercial launch vehicle. I'll give a mention to a concept I like as an alternative to Vulcan Plus tankers. Take a Starship depot and refuel it, then send it out to NIHO for refueling purposes. With 8 launches, you could theoretically get enough propellant for 5 landings, compared to the 20 Vulcan plus tanker launches it would take to match that. It removes a lot of the launch constraints from the architecture. Effectively, every single landing past the first becomes a single launch landing, and if you had an alternative method of getting crew to NRHO, the lander would be ready with less prep. Plus, for more extraneous missions, it is actually 5 Vulcan tanker launches. Obviously, SpaceX would have to figure out effective multi-year cryogenic propellant storage, but there's mass tweak here to account for that. I think on a technical level, Alpaca will be in a fine spot after spending the past 2 years maturing their architecture. But in their competition with Blue, I feel like the price will come out in favor of Blue. Blue can match something like SpaceX's $4 billion with Bezos' billions, whereas Dynetics kinda doesn't have that money to chuck around, and so they will have to price more conservatively.